Jamie Hirsch. The NHL trade deadline is Friday at 3 p.m. Eastern, but don't tell that to GMs around the National. Every day for the last week or so, we've seen some big names being dealt, and on Tuesday, the biggest trade in the rumor mill finally went down. Patrick Kane is headed to the New York Rangers. The future Hall of Famer waived his no-move clause at long last in order to chase a championship in the Big Apple. So here's how it all went down. It was a three-team deal with the Blue Shirts, Blackhawks, and Coyotes. The Rangers also receive a prospect from the Hawks. Chicago gets a prospect and two draft picks from the Rangers and another prospect from Arizona. The Elks receive a third-round pick from New York, and both the Hawks and the Coyotes retain some of Kane's remaining salary. So Kane is expected to debut for the Rangers on Thursday against the Senators at Madison Square Garden. So I guess you could say it's going to be showtime on Broadway. Kane tweeted a statement shortly after the trade saying, "Chicago, there simply are no words to express my family's love and appreciation for the Blackhawks organization, my teammates, this city, and the greatest fans in the world welcoming me here since being drafted in 2007. Thank you for giving me a chance and supporting me like your own through 1,297 games played in the most iconic sweater, including three Stanley Cups and thousands of memories to last a lifetime." Blackhawks general manager Kyle Davidson was emotional after trading away the face of the franchise.
A lot of emotions, to be honest. You know, it doesn't seem real right now. You know, we traded Patrick Kane, but really excited for him to get a chance to play for the Rangers, play at Madison Square Garden with a really good team, and we're looking forward to watching him compete with New York.
Okay, so the other big trade on Tuesday saw the Oilers pick up longtime Predators defenseman Mattias Ekholm and a 2024 second-round pick in exchange for Tyson Barrie, Reed Schaefer, and two draft picks. The 32-year-old Ekholm is in the first year of a four-year, $25 million contract. He has spent his entire 12-season career with Nashville after being drafted by the Preds in 2009. On Tuesday evening, he discussed how he can help the Oilers take their next postseason step.
I mean, I've been in the playoffs for eight straight years and think that we've had some decent success. We haven't obviously came to the ultimate goal of winning a Stanley Cup, but we've been pretty close in 17. And I think I have a pretty good sense of what it takes to shut guys down in the playoffs. And that's probably why I'm sitting here today, that they acquired me, is for my defense and for my defensive side of the puck. So trying to contribute the way I played the game and have been for the last decade in this league. So not going to come there and be anything different from what I have been and what I'm trying to accomplish with my game. And I think you guys have all seen me play before. So that's what you guys should expect.
All righty then. And that wasn't the only move the Oilers made on Tuesday, sending Jesse Puljujarvi to the Hurricanes for a prospect. Meanwhile, the Wild made two deals, getting Marcus Johansson from the Capitals for a third-round pick and Gustav Nyquist from Columbus for a fifth-rounder. Nyquist, by the way, is currently out with a shoulder injury, but he is expected to be ready by the end of the regular season. Kyle Dubas and the Leafs were also busy on Tuesday, pulling off three deals. Rasmus Sandin goes to Washington for Erik Gustafsson and a first-rounder. Luke Shen is headed to Toronto from Vancouver for a third-rounder, and the Leafs pick up a third-round draft pick from the Islanders for Pierre Engvall. For more on all of these moves, here's our NHL Tonight crew of Bill Pito, Mike Rupp, and Sam Cosentino.
All right, Jamie, thank you so much. So, guys, finally, cap experts in New York and Chicago can exhale, can put the calculators away. The deal is done. Mike, Kane to the Rangers. What's it going to mean for them?
It's huge. I mean, we're talking about the power surges, I guess, off the ice as far as trades in this division, in this conference. It's been going on for a while now, and the Rangers got more dangerous. And they were already a team that was very dangerous, right? They get Patty Kane, and he seems very motivated right now. He wanted to be a New York Ranger. He's going to get that opportunity, and there's a lot to be cooking here, Sam. I mean, you talk about his relationship with Bread. I mean, just Showtime coming to Broadway. I mean, it's interesting. 88 and is a blue shirt. It's going to look kind of weird.
It's going to look
but
weird.
But I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, and it brings them that additional layer of swagger that if they didn't already have enough with the New York Rangers, they definitely have more of that now. But now what you think about are the options for Gerard Gallant in that top six. You know, you've got Kreider, you got VCU's played so well. Maybe he gets bumped down a little bit. You look at Kane, Tarasenko, Trocheck. There is a wealth of riches up front. But the one thing that's remained consistent, and he's gone away from it a couple of times this year, is that kid line. That kid line really is a wild card because, yeah, we're really certain about all that skill in the top six. If the kid line continues to play as it did against LA the other night, Lafreniere, Hedl, and Kako, man, oh, man. Now you're looking at a fourth line that is nasty business, not fun to play against. You got Mott, he runs around, Goudreau with the size and winning draws in the middle, and now you bump VC down into a space where you hope that he can produce in that fourth line, kind of the same way he did in the top six when he had the opportunity to play there, yet still utilize that great skill. So you have to love your, if you're Gerard Glenn, all the options you have.
Chris Drury has done his job as far as getting this team in a situation to be on paper. I mean, we didn't even look at their, we don't need to, but look at their D and their goaltenders. I mean, this is as loaded as a group you're going to get in the NHL. Maybe the Boston Bruins are another one that toe for toe across the lineup, you could be like, that's really good. Might take some time. Power play, again, Patty Kane plays that same position on the power play that Artemi Panarin plays, and that's a really good power play. It's a driving force for the Rangers and has been since last year, right? So there's a lot of players that are not going to maybe get all the touches they normally get, so you have to find a way to maybe take some sacrifice. You got Goodrow and VC playing less minutes, so it's going to take them a little bit. It might take time, but they got 22 games to figure this out, and this is a loaded group.
Speaking of a loaded group, let's take a look at what Toronto has done and look at the additions. Of course, O'Reilly and Achari, previously from St. Louis. In recent days, they got McCabe, Shen, and Gustafson done here on the last day of February. What does this say now, Sam, about the Leafs' defense?
They've entirely remade their back end. And I go back to a game before the break where they played against the Boston Bruins. Boston manhandled. The third pairing that night was Timothy Liljegren and Rasmus Sandin, and it didn't make the cut. And Kyle Dubas, I think, realized at that point that that was going to have to change. So changes they have made now. They've gotten older, nastier. I think they're okay with Samsonov in goal. I think they're okay with Matt Murray coming back. But to shore up that defense, and now you look at Giordano, Brody, older, bigger, stronger, nastier, exactly what they needed. And you think about all these guys.
It's nine.
Paul's played all
That's
year.
Nine.
It's nine deep. So maybe there's another move in the offing here for Kyle Dubas to move one of those guys out. But, man, that's a lot of experience that they didn't have previous to this trade.
It's nine deep, and depending on what your opponent is, depending on what stage in a series, you can switch it up, you can change it up. They've done already the things up front with the O'Reilly deal and Noel Achari. I'd love what Kyle Dubas has done, and I am one that has been very vocal who hasn't loved a lot of the moves the Leafs have made over the last couple of years. They've done great in the last couple weeks. But I think this team's loaded as well.
But what do they have waiting? Tampa Bay? And if you're able to get by Tampa Bay, you weren't able to do that in seven games last year, then you got the big bad
bees. Might need nine defensemen.
You might need all nine of them.
And then in the Atlantic, you got who you're talking about. And the Metro, you got the Devils, the Rangers, and also Carolina.
Yeah. Good times.
We have a developing situation. Amy, back to you.
Yes, we do, Bill, because early Wednesday morning, this blockbuster deal broke. The Blue Jackets and Kings have reportedly agreed on a deal that will send defenseman Vladislav Gavrikov and goalie Jonas Korpisalo to L.A. in exchange for longtime netminder Jonathan Quick and draft compensation. So this certainly looks like the end of an era in L.A. as Jonathan Quick was drafted by the Kings in the third round back in 2005 and has spent his entire 16-year NHL career in Los Angeles. He led the Kings to two Stanley Cup championships, won the Conn Smythe Trophy in 2012, and currently holds the record for most games played, wins, and shutouts among goalies in Kings franchise history. The 2023 NHL trade deadline is this Friday at 3 p.m. Eastern. NHL Network will have full coverage throughout the day leading up to the deadline itself, and then we'll recap all the big deals on NHL Tonight and On the Fly. We have seen a lot of players change sweaters over the last week, and a couple of them are already making an impact with their new teams. We'll show you the highlights when On the Fly returns. Welcome back. Let's get to the Battle of the Sunshine State in Tampa.
Here's Lomberg down low, back to Cousins. Uhura gets it to the net, deflected, score! It's Eric Stoll. Stoll got a piece of it out in front, and the Panthers break out on top, 1-0.
And here they work it around. They'll eventually kick it back to the point. Cousins, and there you'll see Stoll. Watch him right there, right down along the ice. And there it goes.
The Lightning into it. The Panthers dominating right now. Lundell in after the loose puck. He's got a chance. Score! Anton Lundell. And the Panthers have themselves a 2-0 lead in Tampa.
Here it is. There's the turnover, the poke there by Tkachuk, and here comes Lundell. He's in full speed, and he just cuts towards the net and just picks the far side right underneath the blocker of Vasilevsky. There's a different angle of it, and a huge goal.
Sending it in front, Montour backs it just wide. Here's Duclair again, trying to jam it home to feed the shot. They score! The Duke sets up Lostjarinen, and the Panthers lead it 3-0 in Tampa Bay.
Here comes Duclair. He eyes the situation, flips it out in front, then there's Batten, it just goes wide, and then Tampa gives up the puck again, and Duclair brings it to the front of the net. It's knocked off of Duclair's stick, and there's Lostjarinen in the perfect position and drills it home. Boy, he nuked that one.
Step in, and against Stoll, cuts back in the corner now. Urbics. And now we get a whistle. So Mark Stahl's in the box for holding. Here's Tampa Bay's first power play of the night. Sergachev holds the line, gives it up to Kucherov. Backs it up into the corner, across. Stamkos in front, they score! Another power play goal for Braden Point.
Braden Point is one of the top producers in the NHL in shots from the slot, because that's his spot on the power play.
37 goals on the season now for Point. Comes to the boards, work back to the line, head been across. Kucherov moves in, his shot kicked out, rebound, and Bobrovsky's got that in the glove.
Tampa net is empty now. Sergachev with a shot, Bobrovsky the big save, rebound Bobrovsky with another one. And another faceoff win. Gudas got it to center, the net is empty for Eric Stoll. He's looking for Duclair, and the Duke gets his first of the season.
When the net was empty for the Tampa Bay Lightning, they win the draw, Lostjarinen around the boards. They get a very good bounce, and there's Stoll. Unselfish play, gives Duclair his first of the year.
And the Panthers get a big one. They win it 4-1, and congratulations to Sergei Bobrovsky. It's win number 354, and he has the most wins in NHL history by a Russian-born goaltender.
And the Panthers with a huge road win.
You can say that again. Yeah, the Cats jumped out to a 3-goal lead in the first and never looked back, beating the Bolts 4-1 to earn an important 2 points. Sergei Bobrovsky stopped 28 of the 29 shots he faced, and Anthony Duclair found the empty net for his first goal of the season in just his second game back from an Achilles injury. After the game, Bobrovsky spoke about this win.
Yeah, it's just like one shot at a time. You know, we know how dangerous they are on the power play and the offensive side of the game. So it's take all of us, you know, like everybody we're on the same page. It's, and we beat a really good team. Yeah, it's a great building, you know. Fans give the create the good atmosphere. You know, it's electric. It's so much fun to play here, and even more fun to win. We're not thinking too much ahead, so it's just tomorrow have a good rest, get ready for Nashville, and get 2 points against them.
So after a big win in Tampa, the Panthers return home for a season-long 7-game homestand starting on Thursday against the Predators. The Cats have been significantly better on home ice this season, and fortunately for them, 13 of their final 20 games will be played at FLA Live Arena as they make a push for the postseason. One of the teams they're chasing is the Islanders, and they were in Minnesota on Tuesday.
And Ryan Reeves will drop the gloves here against Ross Johnston. We're just over 2 minutes in, and this is a message-sending bout, no doubt about it. Johnston hasn't been a regular in the Islander lineup lately. He was inserted tonight just for this reason.
A couple of jabs on Reeves. Johnston's got to get inside. Reeves just arms are longer.
Johnston got a couple shots in early, but Reeves certainly got the better of this one as the fight progressed.
Number 32, New York. Number 75, Minnesota.
Otto Koivula sees Mayfield, gets it to him. Scott Mayfield rips a shot, knocked down, they score! Josh Bailey collects the rebound and gives the Islanders the lead.
Potential two-on-one and two-on-two, and he just hangs onto it long enough, creates time and space for himself on the top of the left. Little quick little pass right in the middle of the ice. There's Mayfield, and Mayfield looking for Ross Johnston, provides the screen, but Josh Bailey slides in. So when your fourth line gets a goal, Brendan, that's a good start for the Isles. Josh Bailey's got to feel good about that one.
His first goal in 24 games, his seventh of the season.
Reeves drops to Greenway, saves Sorokin. Reeves scores! A fight and a goal tonight for Ryan Reeves, and Jordan Greenway will snap a 21-game string without a point on the helper. Minnesota ties it 1-1.
Well, Ryan Reeves should get an assist on his own goal here, but how about the athletes in this family? His brother's a football player. He's a boxer to start off the night, skating a little bit, out of the air, backhand. But maybe this guy should be playing baseball, too.
Romanov got there before Kaprizov.
But a good no-call from the ref.
Romanov cuts in, and a sliding save by Gustafson. What a chance for Bo Horvat.
Well, Horvat, again, these are the saves that Gustafson makes. He just covers the lower half of the net.
And for the sixth time in the last 10 games, Minnesota will be heading into overtime.
Addison's alone. They send it ahead. Kalen Addison. Ryan Pulock got back, took it off.
Go.
Addison into the goal. The Islanders have numbers. 3-on-2 ahead. Nelson, Pulock, and Parisi. Nelson to Pulock to Parisi, and Gustafson makes two saves on Zach Parisi.
Addison opens up, but how about the defensive play here? Pokes his puck off from Pulock.
Parisi in a great solid move, pushing hard to go from left to right.
Freddie Gaudreau comes in wide right and then drifting back. A lot of movement and it off the glove and in. Sorokin thought he had it. It dribbled through. And Freddie Gaudreau scores the first goal of the shootout. Islanders need a goal. Paul Murray slows up, shoots. Gustafson makes the save. Another disappointing shootout for the New York Islanders, going 0-4-3. But the Wild get the extra point tonight.
Yeah, the Wild outlast the Islanders in a low-scoring affair, picking up the extra point in the shootout. Ryan Reeves scored his first of the season, and Philip Gustafson outdueled Ilya Sorokin, making a career-high 39 saves plus three more stops in the shootout as the Wild extend their point streak to 7 games. Afterward, Freddie Gaudreau discussed his team's success in tight games.
Yeah, we've played a lot of one-goal games this season. We're comfortable in this situation. It's our style of game. We're tight defensively, and like always, we believe that when we're tight defensively, good things happen to us. So
the last couple weeks, we've really found something with the way we're going to win hockey games. It's important to play tight games like this against good teams, and you know, learn to keep your emotions in check and stay level-headed, and you know, keep sticking with the way you're supposed to be playing the game. So we've been doing it now for a while, a lot this year. So we're getting pretty good at it.
Let's head to Winnipeg for the Kings and Jets.
Nino Niederreiter, he is the newest Winnipeg Jet, and he's the type of player the Jets need right now.
Josh Morrissey, he'll try to walk away from Arvidsson, shoots, put it wide, and it comes off the skate, it looks like, poking at it, score! Shankly jammed it off the goaltender! Somebody put it in, and it's 1-0 Winnipeg. Great look at it from the top, it is Morrissey's goal, his 12th. Shankly knew he'd play a price there too, he did. But it all combines to get the Jets a much-needed goal. Shifley comes over to help, and time for Morrissey to walk. Morrissey shoots, scores! 2 in a row for Josh Morrissey. 2-0 Winnipeg.
And this season has felt like a star has been born, a leader finding another level.
Fiala across, they score! It only took 6 seconds! And Andre Kopitar buries it.
Gives the puck to Kyle Connor with a shot, he scores!
Field Deeks drifts to the blue line. Adler's shot deflects in. Andre Kopitar with his second. And the Kings are back within one.
Kopitar wins it back.
Dowdy shot tipped in. Kopitar, a hat trick. Andre Kopitar with a hat trick in this period.
Wow. Jersey falls. There's a drive by Stedlin and he scores. Kevin Stedlin is first in 13 and the Jets have regained the lead. Niederreiter was knocked down behind the plate. Fans loving this game tonight. Niederreiter hammers his man to the ice, and that's going to draw a crowd.
Yeah, he flattened him, and I thought it was a clean hit. This tends to happen when the referees let so much blatant penalties, in my opinion, go.
How do you become a fan favorite in a hurry and lay the body like that in your first game as a Jet? Lowry will carry it in. Trailing is Stenlund. Kevin Stenlund scores! A pair of goals for Stenlund. That's shorthanded, and it's 5-3.
Certainly okay here. Here's Kopitar. Slap shot, he scores! Number 4 for Kopitar tonight. It is Kopitar's second career 4-goal game, and the Kings are back within one. Lazat for Vilardi. He has room. Vilardi scores! They've come back again to tie it. It's Gabe Vilardi. We've got a brand new game. Steps up with speed. Connor cuts to the middle, slows down. Stick has Copley with the left leg. Kept it out.
It's low, and then up. Oh, he just gets it up.
Adrian Kempe. Mike Tweeners. Scores! 5-hole. He must score to keep the game going. Wheeler stops up. Fires off the glove of Copley, and the Kings win it in comeback fashion.
My goodness, the Kings mount a multi-goal third period comeback for a league-leading fourth time this season. Josh Morrissey had a great night for the Jets, recording 2 goals and 2 helpers, but it doesn't beat Andre Kopitar, who became the oldest player in Kings history to score 4 goals in a single game. After the game, he was proud of the resilience of his team in this comeback.
Yeah, it was a big win. I mean, obviously happy to contribute, but show the character that, being down multiple times, coming back and ultimately winning the shootout. It's 2 very big points for us.
We needed a comeback, and it was one of these games. We didn't play our best game. I think we had some better games on the road lately, but I mean, I think it was a character win, and we'll deserve 2 points after some games where we didn't get any points.
Back to Kopi. This is the second time that he's tallied 4 times in a game, but this time he does it at the age of 35. Scoring a hat trick is hard enough, but to score 4 at this stage in his career is pretty impressive. He joins the list of some of the more recent ageless wonders to accomplish that feat. Let's head out to Calgary now for the Bruins and Flames.
The big game for the Calgary Flames. Ryan mentioned the Bruins, the top team in the league on a 7-game winning streak. Can the Flames stop it? We will find out next. Dmitry Orlov shoots and scores! The Flames gave away the ice, and Orlov takes it for his first goal as a Bruin. Elias Lindholm, Huberdeau, a save by Omark. Mano a mano, Omark. Bergeron, Marchand, and DeBrusque. Orlov scores his second! Dmitry Orlov has 4 points in the last 4 periods! Elias Lindholm, Dylan Dubé, and a great save by Omark. 20 minutes of Linus Omark at one end and Dmitry Orlov at the other.
Anderson, good job to get to it first to keep it alive with a pass to the slot to Coleman. Scores! Blake Coleman rips it home. Flames on the board. And the Bruins going on their second power play.
Elias Lindholm to Mikhail Backlund with a shorthanded chance. And Omark makes a brilliant blocker save. 2-on-1, Lucic and Dour. And Lucic, oh, what a save by Omark! Linus Omark with the save of the game. Cross ice, Clifton gets a piece, and Lucic can't jam it home after being denied on the backhand by Omar. Orlov steps up to the red line. Foligno runs into Zadorov, and he's hurt. Nick Foligno laboring off the ice. Grizzly gives it away to Hanifin. Kadri to Huberdeau, a save and a rebound save by Omark. Linus Omark, a tour de force. Zadorov, the shot, perhaps intentionally wide, and Tyler Toffoli can't elevate. Omark has been nothing less than brilliant tonight.
Now, are up 2-1, a pair of goals by Orlov. Here's Dubé! Dylan Dubé fires it home and we're all even. Murray trying to get to it. Bouncing puck, put it in front. Huberto, they score! Peltier from Huberto, and it's 3-2 Calgary.
What we thought was a beautiful pass by Huberto to Peltier goes off the toe of the Bruins defenseman.
The 4-on-3 power play. Oh, a huge hit. The two Flames collide. Pass in front, they score!
Dmitry Orlov with a 3-point night. And Saka ties the game. 48 saves in the 60-minute regulation time.
Hooked in by McAvoy. Cuts to the middle. Still has it. Pass in. Great save by Markstrom. What a stop by Jacob Markstrom in overtime.
It's off the apron. Marchand to Bergeron. McAvoy scores! They pull one out of the rabbit's hat. Linus over. Stood on his head. 54 saves.
So despite getting outshot 57-20, the Bruins still managed to come away with a victory in overtime, extending their winning streak to 8 games. Charlie McAvoy ended it with the OT winner powered by Energizer, and recent trade acquisition Dmitry Orlov made his presence felt with 2 goals and an assist. But it was Linus Ullmark who really stole this one for Boston, stopping 54 of the 57 shots that he faced for his league-leading 31st win of the season. That marks a new career high for the 29-year-old, 10 more than his previous best, and sets a Bruins franchise record for most saves in a regular season game. Congrats. Well, the Senators put up 6 goals on the Red Wings on Monday, and unfortunately for Detroit, it was a case of deja vu on Tuesday. We've got the highlights from a big night in Ottawa and much more when On the Fly returns. Welcome back. Well, in case you missed it, the Rangers add 3-time Cup winner Patrick Kane. The Oilers add strength on the blue line in Matthias Ekholm. The Maple Leafs add a pair of veteran defensemen in Luke Shen and Erik Gustafsson. And the Wild add depth to their forward lines with Gustav Nyquist and Marcus Johansson. For more on potential trades that we might see later on this week, here's Elliot Friedman.
If you take a look at some of the trades this week, the Coyotes feel they are justified in their asking price, which is basically 2 first-rounders plus or 2 first-round talents plus. The Coyotes have been emboldened by what's happened this week. I think we're looking at teams like, you know, potentially L.A. We're looking at teams like maybe Washington, although they traded for Rasmus Sandin today, so I'm not sure if they have it. I'm still wondering a little bit about Pittsburgh, although I think they're talking about another move today with Vancouver, potentially for Brock Besser. I still think Columbus is around this. I still think potentially Winnipeg is around this. And I always wonder about teams that I haven't named. So I do think that the market is still hot. I think there is a desire this week for this to end. I think for both player and team, it's time. And I think they're really trying. And the Coyotes have been emboldened by some of the returns this week to say, our ask is fair. So we'll see where it goes. Besser, I think, as the week has gone on, I really think that it's become a little more likely. I think a lot of the focus right now is on, you know, the Penguins. Would they be willing to do something like that? I think there's some steam. I wouldn't want to say a percentage of it, but I've had points where people have been very optimistic, and then I've had points where people have cooled a bit. But there's definitely some conversation there.
An additional move announced Tuesday. The Capitals have re-signed defenseman Nick Jensen to a 3-year contract extension with an AAV of $4.05 million. The 32-year-old has 2 goals and 22 helpers in 62 games this season. Let's get out to Nashville for the Penguins and Preds.
Wake up, it's a breakaway. First 30 seconds, wrist shot gets denied. Tristan Jarry. Another save from the angle.
Oh, Granlund, what a heads-up play that was. That 150-foot pass to him at the far blue line. Tristan Jarry makes it early in this one.
Throw to the net, tip. Save made by Saros. And a second stop as well. 2 best saves of the night so far. Another one-timer. Saved by Saros, and he holds. A flurry by Pittsburgh. Then the juice shut him down.
All of a sudden, here we go. They put a lot of pressure on. There's going to be times in this hockey game where Pittsburgh is going to put you under siege, and that's where number 74 comes into play. He's done it all season.
Now they take over on the power play. Crosby playing catch. Here's Letang to the far side. The one-timer! Save made behind Saros.
and alertly McDonough kicks it back onto the pads of his goalie.
Yeah, smart play for McDonough, senses the danger, uses his goaltender juice with a couple big saves.
Here's Sherwood with a shot denied by Jari.
It's a heavy shot from Kiefer Sherwood. Tristan Jari, Ian Saros, both locked in tonight.
22-21 for Nashville. These goaltenders have really been fun to watch. Vangelista twists around one man. Stolen in front. Two on one. Jankowski, he scores! Mark Jankowski breaks the ice. Waved, cleared waivers, sent to Milwaukee, comes back. And because of the trade, he's in the lineup tonight, and he gets the first goal of the game. Not even officially on the roster until early. Here's a steal by Evangelista. He sends it wide.
The game, as long as this game, look at him.
Look at this. Oh, he's got people coming
and
out.
And he draws a penalty. Penalties.
What a shift there by Evangelista. Welcome to the show, kid.
Say, hey, boys, I should be here. Look at me.
Now he's chirping. He's the guy is on the bench. Crosby's chirping him right now in his first game.
Quick up, Crosby, breakaway, and he scores! Captain Clutch, Sidney Crosby, ties the game up at one for the Penguins.
Pass two players right to Malkin, runs out of room, losing it was McDonough to the net, score!
And the Penguins have the lead! Jason Zucker, 1:39 to go. Now to Josi, wide slap pass is fought off, big scramble, chaos around the crease. Tristan Jari comes up with the cover, 19.6 to go. It stays at 2-1. Racing after it is Russ, diving effort. Did he do it? He did. Brian Russ lunging and he sweeps it into the open net for the put away in Nashville.
And how does Russ get to that puck?
And the Penguins come up with a big victory here in Nashville tonight. That was huge.
We waited until the third period for some goals, but the Penguins scored three unanswered in the final frame to leave Nashville with a significant win over the Preds. The Penguins have now won three straight for the first time since mid-December, outscoring their opponents 13-6 in that span. Out to Buffalo for the Jackets and Sabres.
Yeah, and this penalty kill for this Buffalo team has been one of the major weak spots. The team only 72.8% on the year.
Johnson scores! Kent Johnson off the rush with the second power play unit. Snipes one, and Columbus strikes first on the road.
Kent Johnson with an absolute missile from the left circle.
Four Tate Thompson goals and a 6-0 start in the first period. Part of nine goals where Buffalo scored the first time. Thompson comes back and scores! Oh, you said it. He likes facing the Jackets. This game is tied at one.
I'm telling you, sometimes there's just a team you enjoy playing against. Thompson showing off his shot right here.
Shadowed by Owen Power. Olivier dropped it down toward Corrali. Corrali pivoting behind the net. Out in front, Robinson loads it up and scores! The Blue Jackets lead again on a snipe from Eric Robinson.
Comes in low, but watch, everybody starts to watch the puck here. Corrali has control of it and leaves the center of the ice open there.
Line A Shields fight for the puck. Corrali just out of the ice. Keeps it for Columbus. And Robinson's got his second. He scores, and the lead is 2 for Columbus on a workmanlike shift.
Robinson again. They caught a tired Buffalo Sabres team.
Jenner weaving through, and he scores. Oh, that was gorgeous by Boone Jenner. And the lead is 4-1 for the Jackets on the road.
Wow, is Boone Jenner serious with that, Mike? Holy cow.
As some boos rain out here in Buffalo. Marchenko ride it out toward the slot, but onto Samuelson's stick. And up ahead for Buffalo. Quinn races forward. He shoots and scores! The Sabres needed that.
That's exactly what the Sabres needed. A little shot of energy and emotion into this building and into this team, and it's Jack Quinn who delivers it. Buffalo tries to adjust to it, gets some guys in front of that like power hammer.
Marchenko serving too many men. Here's Thompson, works his way in. Oh, what a stop by Merzlikins.
Merzlikins with absolutely robbery as Tage Thompson breaks free on a breakaway, goes through, ends up going through three defenders of the Columbus Blue Jackets.
Power for Krebs. Back for Power. Straight on. Katurka scores!
they're trying to get their top line out there. The Thompson line is stuck on the bench right now.
It's a foot race. Here's Robinson. He scores to complete a hat trick and stamp it for Columbus. How's that for your first career hat trick in the National Hockey League?
You're in a playoff chase playing last place team in the league right now. And at home, these are the games you have to win. If you miss the playoffs, these are the ones you want.
The Blue Jackets put together another solid performance, taking down the Sabres 5-3 behind Eric Robinson's first career hat trick. Columbus has earned points in six of its last seven games, with wins over the Jets, Stars, Oilers, and now Sabres in that span. Impressive. Meanwhile, Buffalo snaps its three-game win streak and will be in Boston on Thursday. Let's head to Ottawa now to see the Red Wings and Senators.
Last night's game wasn't pretty, so now it's time to turn it too ugly. Here's a lead pass for Kubalik. Scores!
Oh,
and mixing it up right after, but Dominic Kubalik has given the Red Wings a 1-0 lead. 13 of his 17 goals now have come on the road for Dominic Kubalik.
Here's Stutzle with a chance, gets by Bertuzzi. What a move by Stutzle. Works in, and looks that wide, a penalty coming. And it's going to be a hooking call against the Red Wings.
Bertuzzi not done?
No.
What did I say to you before the game?
What's the odds on him getting a fight in the first 10 minutes?
You got it.
Ottawa number 18 has been awarded a penalty shot for being fouled from behind.
Long winding path in, and Stutzle scores! By Jim Stutzla. He empties the trick bucket and ties the game at one. Kolachuk with it now. Jim's short-handed. In comes Austin Watson. Watson in, scores! Austin Watson, short-handed goal.
This is Austin Watson's second goal in his last three games.
This youngster was jacked up last night.
Fired up again tonight.
On the Lightning early on. Castle, backhand shot. Shot by Huza. Played by McCoy. They score! Austin Watson's got two. He got two with a high stick.
Plays, pays a price to go to the front of the net. First and foremost, you got to make sure he's all right. Lets the crowd know he's all right as he heads off to get some repairs.
And Ottawa leads by two. Travis and McIntyre score! Alex to break it.
Wow. What a turn of events here. But the puck movement by the Senators was elite on that play, and they find the back of the net.
Thomas Chabot crisscrossing with Kachuk. Pass misfired for Stutzle. Kachuk was spilled in front of the penalty box. A penalty coming to Detroit, and Kachuk is slow to get out. That's not a good sign for Ottawa as he's in some distress. Picked up by Giroux. Low Giroux throws it back and scores! That went by everything. A seeing eye shot by Giroux. Another power play goal. It's 5-1.
And if you look, there's a screen in front by Kachuk who waves at it. Now he immediately points at Claude Giroux, saying, that's your goal. I didn't touch it.
And Kachuk still giving it to the Red Wing. Sanderson to Stutzla. Back for Giroux. He's got a lane. Lions and fire scores!
Kachuk gets a little piece of the score. He touches it, and
Kachuk.
It elevates on the play. A little muscle pose from the captain as he rubs in the sixth goal.
Race back here for Joseph. Off stride hit by Simon Joseph in the line. Here they go.
This debacle continues here in Ottawa. Still a minute 32 to go. This has been a demoralizing trip to Ottawa for the Red Wings. And the Ottawa Senators continue their winning ways. They're within 3 points of the final playoff spot.
How about that? After beating the Red Wings 6-2 on Monday night, the Senators dominated Detroit once again 6-1 on Tuesday. Ottawa's PK went 8-for-8, and Tim Stützle led the way offensively with a goal and two helpers as the Sens notched their 10th win in their last 14 games. Here's Derek Lalonde on the Red Wings' tough two games against the Senators.
Obviously, of course, a missed opportunity, especially the way we've been playing of late, where we were in the standings. But, you know, it goes back to what got us into this race. We just need to take care of our game, and that's something we did not do in this past 48 hours. Give our guys credit. We've done a pretty good job of bouncing back with these situations all year. So I can ask the guys. We have an opportunity at home on Thursday. Hopefully get some momentum.
So with the Sens win over the Red Wings, there are now 7 teams separated by just 6 points in the Eastern Conference wildcard race. The Islanders gained a point in their shootout loss in Minnesota to keep their hold on the top wildcard spot, and the Penguins closed the gap on New York after their win over Nashville. And despite their loss on Tuesday, the Sabres do remain within striking distance, and they have the most games remaining of any team in the race. How about the Western Conference? Let's go to St. Louis for the Kraken and Blues.
Now the Kraken to center ice. Geeky comes in with Tanev and a shot, and he scores! Morgan Geeky is sixth on a 2-on-1, and the Kraken lead 1-0.
And boy, does he ever have a lot of whip on that stick right there. Boy, that thing was humming.
So the Kraken 20% this year on the power play. And Darren, in their brief history, they have never scored a power play goal against the Blues. The Blues have killed all 12. As Thomas darts in, shoots, he scores! A shorthanded goal by Robert Thomas. And we're tied at one.
Well, you talk about the element of surprise. And Robert Thomas makes Martin Jones pay a premium.
Kelly Tolvanen with patience to the line. He gets it back from Wenberg. Out of the box, it's Pitlick, and now McCann with a shot. He scores! A bomb from 19, 27 goals for Jared McCann at the tail end of the power play, and the Kraken have a one-goal lead.
And now Falk will steer it back to the goal for Letty. Saw it ahead of the pack. He's got a partial break. Shoots. He scores! Saad ties it!
And there's Saad, just rips this one here. A clean shot that beats the goaltender, Martin Jones.
It redirects home, Morgan Geeky. In the right place at the right time off the scramble. And with 6:28 left here in the second period, Geeky his second of the game, the Kraken by one. Gord on a turnover, sets up Tolvin, and his shot stopped by Binnington. Donato has the rebound. Good pass for Oleksiak. His shot scores! Hey, hey, what do you say? Jamie Oleksiak with relentless pressure from the Kraken. A huge goal. Seattle by two.
And now it's Thomas back of the goal. Stole it from Larson in front. Another shot, and they score! Vucevic! And it's now a one-goal game.
Krug spins it off his own man. A chance developed possibly off Borgen. Played outside the line by Krug. 11 seconds left. Gord, Tolvanen, Tanev, empty net, bullseye! The three-game skid is history, and the Kraken are back in the win column with a total team effort and a 5-3 win over St. Louis.
The Kraken get back on track after a three-game skid and hand the Blues their sixth straight loss in Jaden Schwartz's return to St. Louis. Morgan Geeky grabs his first two-goal game in nearly 2 years, and with his three helpers, Eli Tolvanen is up to 18 points in 26 games since joining Seattle. The Blackhawks face the Coyotes in their first official game without Patrick Kane, and the new era got off to a bad start. Could the Hawks recover? Find out when On the Fly returns.
The end of an era in Chicago. The Blackhawks say farewell to the great 88, Patrick Kane, as they get ready to take on the Arizona Coyotes from Mullet Arena.
We have a late-breaking development. Healthy scratches tonight, Jacob Chychrun and Nick Bjugstad, the team saying for trade-related reasons. Stripped away by Boyd, he brings it in. Travis Boyd with the shot, he scores! Travis Boyd, 1-0.
Individual effort.
Handcuffs the goaltender.
And the Coyotes, they strike first.
That line staying out of Michelli, Kraus, and McBain. Big hit, Jack McBain, Tenorti. And now they're going to go. Tenorti and McBain.
Oh, boy. Those are haymakers from downtown.
I don't miss those days.
Schmaltz. Sent towards the front, it goes in. It was deflected in front of Stalock, and the Coyotes lead it 2-0.
They might take a peek at this one here. It was real close. What a deflection, though, nonetheless, by that man right there, Barrett Hayden.
All right, so Jordan Samuels-Thomas says it's a good goal. Max Domi, challenge, turnover here, Stetcher! Oh, he can't put it on, rebound! Coyotes all over, and it goes in.
And I think it's going to be McBain's goal. 3-0. Your guess is as good as mine.
That puck hops up and over the right shoulder of Max Domi, and nobody can swat it.
And now Keller. Weak one. Schmuck scores! Oh, we've seen that a few times. 4-0.
Nick Schmaltz continues to roll. How about 11 goals in his last 13 games?
And that's going to do it. And the Coyotes get a big night, and they win it 4-1.
The Sharks debuting two new players tonight, Fabian Zetterlund and Andreas Johnsson. They're both on this line with Hurdle. A chance for Svechnikov. Bad, but they score! Jacob McDonald! His first goal is a Shark, and it's 1-0.
Broken play. I love McDonald cruising into that slot, looking for a loose puck.
Well, anything that makes the senior director of scouting happy must be good. Here's Hoffman. Suzuki in the slot. He was back-checked. Gooley winds up, score! Welcome back, Keenan Gooley buries one, and we're all tied up at one. He missed 23 games, and what an impact in game number one back for Montreal.
108 minutes and 7 seconds. That Kaapo Kähkönen has kept Montreal off the board. Kähkönen doesn't really get himself into the position, and it slips right between the legs. Certainly evidence of that happening for the Montreal fan.
Graham Pitlick, get a low. Pitlick passes across, score! Jesse Ullinen, Habs got the lead, it's 2-1.
Tremendous amount of patience by Red Pitlick. Because as he's moving, he knows he's got an opportunity to shoot it, and it holds Kähkönen. And then as he slides it over to Ullinen, it's a wide open net.
Final seconds. Sharks can't get it in deep. Suzuki this time floats it up ahead. This time open net. This time Dvorak scores. There's your dagger. Empty net goal. Christian Dvorak. And the Habs will win this contest. It's 3-1. And a good battle back from Montreal.
Now it's time for your top shelf plays of the night.
Here's Kopitar, slap shot, he scores! Number 4 for Kopitar tonight! And the Kings are back within one. It is Kopitar's second career 4-goal game. Jenner weaving through, and he scores! Oh, that was gorgeous by Boone Jenner!
Wow, is Boone Jenner serious with that?
2-on-1, Lucic and Dour. Oh, what a save by Linus Ullmark with the save of the game.
As Greenway takes the shot here, and Ryan Reeves with an incredible goal. He knocks it out of midair as he's spinning through the crease, and he ties the score at one.
Marchand to Bergeron. McAvoy scores! They pull one out of the rabbit's hat, and the game ends with 4.3 on the overtime.
Meine Zeit als Dame ist vorbei. Die Zukunft gehört dir.
Aber ich kann dich trainieren.
Die finale Staffel der DC Superhelden-Serie.
Klingt doch ziemlich cool, oder?
Stargirl. Neue Folgen sonntags auf Sky One und auf Abruf.
It's time for your three stars of the night. Our third star goes to Linus Ullmark, who set a new career high with 54 saves in Boston's OT win over Calgary. Eric Robinson gets our second star with his first career hat trick. And our first star is Kings captain Andre Kopitar, who led LA to a comeback win over the Jets with his 4-goal night. What a day off the ice across the hockey world, followed by a great night of games all across the league. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Jamie Hirsch. We'll see you next time.